side with an eighth of a mile to go. Andy's Unreal has been sent on a gate-to-wire mission on the outside.
Hello, everyone. My name is John McMillan. I'm taking a look at the second program of the year.
But Onyx VA and Stéphane Brasseau have the racetrack all to themselves.
Everyone, I'm John McMillan, taking a look at how things went on last Sunday's program.
On the day Canada crossed the threshold of 100 coronavirus cases, Ottawa was explicit for the first time about what researchers say could be on the way.
Are you planning the worst?
Absolutely.
Most cases would feel like a cold, but as many as 25 million Canadians could catch the virus. Daunting numbers calmed by expert advice.
Walking that fine line, being mindful but not going overboard.
With Canadian health, but also jobs and businesses in mind, the Prime Minister says his team is ready.
$1 billion COVID-19 response fund.
But is the world ready?
Alarming levels of inaction.
And so for the first time, these words from the WHO, the coronavirus is officially a pandemic. This is a special edition of The National.
Julie, thank you. Also breaking tonight, the NBA suspending its season after a player on the Utah Jazz test positive for the virus. Dallas Mavericks owner Mark Cuban reacting to the stunner along with the rest of the league and its fans tonight. The Utah-Oklahoma City game was postponed right before tip-off tonight after that player tested positive, sending a packed arena home.
Pete, are we still racing?
Dylan, we just got off the phone with Ontario Racing, and in line with the other racetracks across Ontario, we will be suspending our race program effective immediately.
For how long?
I don't know.
Horse racing is making its return to the capital this weekend.
But if you're looking to head to the track to catch the excitement, don't. Live audiences are still not allowed, CTV's Tyler Fleming reports.
The race is on. Coming around the backstretch, jockeying for a win.
It's been a long, hard road.
Horse ownership is expensive, and without racing, there's no paycheck for Gary McDonald.
So not only do I have my own financial burden, I have the burden of seven horses.
So a win is needed. Horse racing has been given the go-ahead from the province. These qualifying races at the Rideau-Carlton Raceway are for Sunday's big return.
And hopefully we draw some nice post positions so we can get into the race and get some of that prize money.
A $65,000 purse to be won in the standard bred races.
So that's with the sulky and the driver versus the jockey on top of the thoroughbred's back.
John McMillan is the director of the National Capital Region Horse Association and says the industry has been hit hard.
Participants in the industry are suffering from financial trouble, so getting them back to work will be a great thing.
Strict sanitary measures have been put in place at the track to protect staff, crew, and jockeys. Racing manager Peter Andrusek says only small groups are allowed in the stables and temperatures are being checked before entering.
They've been developed in conjunction with the guidelines of Ottawa Public Health, the AGCO, and Ontario Racing.
Final turn, PL Not So Nice has Trina to contend with, getting closer with every stride. Shapeshifter is to third. There's an eighth of a mile to go. PL Not So Nice is strong. PL Not So Nice and Jonathan Drury have the track record in their sights. PL Not So Nice, a 16th to go, and she's clear by four. PL Not So Nice and Jonathan Drury, the new track record holders, 152-4. Racing at it from third on the inside. That's Rhythm in Motion, up and driving. Here comes Denali Sealster. On the way to three quarters, it's Beaumont Hanover beginning to try to get clear now. opening up a two, maybe three length lead. Aneto is trying to keep tabs from second. Denali Sealster third on the outside. Three quarters and 1:23 and two. Beaumont Hanover has a two length lead. Aneto from second. Rhythm in Motion third. Denali Sealster on the outside. Night Watchman needs to do more, as does Examiner Hanover. There's an eighth of a mile to go. Beaumont Hanover has been sent on a gate to wire mission by Jameson and looks strong coming for the payoff. Beaumont Hanover wins this one with ridiculous ease. Wins it by a solid three over Aneto, finishing third Denali Sealster in a track record equaling 1:50 and two. And it's still Lee DeRose in charge. Best of best Hanover from second. Mick Jagger's on the move, third on the outside. Three quarters, 1:23 and one. On the final turn, Lee DeRose right there, pocket sitting. Best of best Hanover. Mick Jagger's on the move, begins to tire. That sends Vanilla Malt at three wide for the stretch drive. There's an eighth of a mile to go. Lee DeRose trying to get this one home. On the inside, Atomic Million AM. Up on the outside comes Best of Best Hanover. Here is the wire. Lee DeRose will not be denied. Vegas rocks up to be second. Atomic Million AM third in 1:52. Simply pouncing on her tired rivals, and Raisin' a Rocket is pacing away. Raisin' a Rocket is the champion of the Brian Jerome Memorial and completely destroys the field. It's Big Pete Style opening a quick two. Here comes Big Pete Style looking to clear a stubborn but hard-used Mako Polo. It's Big Pete Style to the lead for Gagnon. Big Pete Style is trying to get it home. Big Pete Style gives Gagnon the hat trick early in the card. We'll be right back.